objectives of my session is understanding. Objectives of my case is understanding profound impact on mental state in precipitating state of advanced pathology. There is struggling to identify the exact qualified mental state in Matra Medica through repertory. Exploration of tissue affinities of a remedy in light of developments in molecular biology and correlating it with homeopathic understanding. Understanding posology in advanced pathological cases using principles mentioned in Organon, aphorisms and footnotes. This patient's sisters approached me as her brother was diagnosed as aplastic anemia and he was advised bone marrow transplantation by a hematologist. But due to financial constraint, they are postponing it. I requested them, give me 4 months. If he not gets relief, then you can go for bone marrow. I admitted him in our hospital for observation and collective understanding. He is 32 years old male, studied up to FY BCom, occupation security guard from Hindu Maratha family community. He is from Satara. He has complaint of dyspnea, palpitation, chest pain, weakness, not able to walk, giddiness, headache, petechial spots on legs, gum bleeding, pica, lumbago, since July 2019, and it is rapidly progressing and increasing. All complaints get aggravated by walking, ascending stairs and stooping. He get investigated. At that time, his HB was 1.8. So blood transfusion given, PCV given, and fresh frozen plasma was given. At that time, concomitant was developed like smell of whitener. He was advised bone marrow transplant by hematologist. HLA typing was also done and it is matching with his sister. This is the report at start when he was investigated in July. It was 1.8 HB. This is the bone marrow biopsy report. That is the bone marrow hypocellular hypoplastic marrow with suppressed trilinear series. This is the report when patient get admitted. At that time, his HB was 10.2, WBC is 4,400 and platelets are 22,000. This is the estimate certificate given by hematologist for bone marrow transplant. It is around 15 lakh, which is patient unable to arrange. His personal data, he is 60 kg weight, height 5.5 feet. He has habit of nail biting since childhood, male pattern baldness. His vision was decreased, his stretch around right side, which is better by blood transfusion. Tongue thin white coated, bleeding gums, bilateral pitting edema, perspiration general moderate, especially more on scalp and forehead. Appeared at normal, thus decreased 1 liter per day since 4 months. He has craving for meat, fish, sweets, warm food, aversion for cabbage. Stool two times per day, foul odor, yellow, semi-solid, satisfactory. Urine 4 times a day and once a night, which is reddish and offensive since illness. It shows that bleeding goes in urinary tract. Physical general sleep, he sleeps 10 to 7 p.m. Position right leg bent, so sleep is light and unrefreshing. He has sleep concomitant, sleep talking, startling and snoring. Dreams are not specific. He gets nausea, vomiting and increased salivation during traveling in bus. He gets giddiness when looks down from height. He gets body ache in cloudy weather. He gets coryza cough in every monsoon. He gets headache when gets wet. He is chilly patient. Past history in 6th standard, he gets measles and chickenpox. And 10 years back, he suffered from malaria and prolonged cough cold. Family history, father had history of alcoholism, which is left since 16 years. Mother is rheumatoid arthritis and hysterectomy. Brother is alcoholic and paternal grandfather had leprosy. Patient is 32-year-old security guard from poor family, educated up to FY BCom, and his father is 57 years old farmer, alcoholic, quarrelsome, left alcohol since 16 years. Mother 55 years old housewife, calm and simple lady. Brother 35 years old, educated up to 10th, painter and alcoholic, irresponsible and quarrelsome fellow. Sister 30 years old, educated up to 9th and does work in company. Sister-in-law 30 years old housewife, irritable by nature. His wife is studied up to MA, 30 years old. He had 3 years old son. During childhood, he was very good in studies, but not able to study further due to Family conditions, father's alcoholism and irresponsibility. Father drinks and falls on the road. Father beats him if he opposes for father's drinking. Mother did farm work and ran the house. He got insulting treatment from all relatives and villagers. They all says that Darud has a poor guy. He is alcoholic son. Paternal grandfather and grandmother stayed separate due to father's behavior, which is also impresses patients. Other children calls him bottle, that is the alcoholic bottle, which hurts him a lot. Brother is an alcoholic and always quarrels and beats his wife. Patient took sister-in-law's side and beats brother. He always supported sister-in-law, feels hatred for brother. Father embraces him in childhood and now the brother who is embracing him. He avoids social function due to that. Feels he can't do anything. His dream was to do good job and get respect in the society. He feels he had struggled much, but he can't do anything due to family members. Due to them, he is looked down in the society. Patient is irritable by nature, gets angry on trifles, does not like to take orders from others. He does quarrels, broods over unpleasant talk, feels angry and hateful, speaks hurtfully. He is fault-finding, quarrels readily due to his low tolerance level. He gets panic for future, especially in financial state. Lot of negative thoughts going on. If he is at fault, he apologizes, but again regrets that why he apologized. Does not have smooth relation with anyone. He says he has ego problem. This is the incidence in May 2019, when patient and his family members went for sister-in-law's family marriage. At that time, big quarrel takes place between brother and his wife. Brother beat sister-in-law very badly. Sister-in-law left home and did police case. All family went to police station. When patient was interacting on her side with police, in front of police and all relatives, sister-in-law suddenly turned on him. "You don't speak anything between us and shut your mouth," which was shocking to the patient. As previously, she never argued back with him. Patient felt mortified. Patient said that, "I took care of her like my own sister. I never imagined that she can say this. What is the use of my life? Better I should die than listen this." After that, patient wept a lot. Feels malas kaitari vav. Patient mhanala ki, "Doctor, mi tila bahini sarkha sambhalo. Atapryant mi tujhya bajuni ubha rahilo. Pratyek goshtit majhya bhavala sudha mi marla tujhyasathi. Ani ti mala ashi manli, हे मला अपेक्षितच नव्हतं. असं वाटलं की हे ऐकण्यापेक्षा मी मेलो का नाही, मलाच काहीतरी व्हावं." अँड आफ्टर 2 months ऑफ दिस इन्सिडन्स, इन जुलै 2019 हिज कंप्लेंट स्टार्टेड. इन ऑगस्ट ही गॉट इन्व्हेस्टिगेटेड. ऍट दॅट टाइम हिज एज वॉज 1.9. ऍट दॅट टाइम ही गेट हॉस्पिटल ऍडमिटेड इन अलोपॅथिक हॉस्पिटल अँड गिवन बीपीज. हेमॅटॉलॉजिस्ट ऍडवाइज बोन मॅरो ट्रान्सप्लांट आफ्टर बोन मॅरो बायोप्सी ऑन 14 ऑगस्ट. अँड ही इज नॉट एबल टू अरेंज फायनान्सेस, सो दे अप्रोच मी ऑन 23 ऑक्टोबर. And he get admitted in hospital 26 October. At that time his HbA1c was 10.2, because before just on 22 October he get blood transfusion. So my struggle is to understand why patient is suffering, as there is no causative etiology found in physical form like drug, chemical, radiation or infection. Then why patient is suffering? It has to be immune mediated. Then I visited Organon footnote number 9, that is the most severe diseases may be produced by sufficient disturbances of vital force through the imaginations and also cured by the same means. Then I thought, what signal that mind has given to the body, which is followed by immune system, was that the immune system directed towards the self and destroyed the bone marrow. It has to be faulty perception of the mind, that bone marrow goes on shutting down. The patients appear to be extremely sensitive and responsible. Did the incidents in police station created such an impact on him that he does not desire to live and the bone marrow decided to shut down? So I just taken the rubrics, delusion, he had suffered wrong because of his family. He is not able to do anything. He is looked down in this society. He can't do anything. That's why helplessness and severe anemia, that anemia production of red blood cells impaired. Other rubrics, I thought that is the delusion looked upon she is, delusion failure he is, delusion criminal he is, because he said why I am said this in police station, delusion criticized, suicidal disposition from despair, and blood disorganization. Such rubrics I thought, but I take 3 rubrics: delusion, suffered wrong, helplessness, and production of red cell blood cells impaired, and in repertorization, lacacid, china, and lysine coming forward. So I consider
that. Aya, aya.
China 201 packet with considering susceptibility, moderate and infrequent repetition. I differentiated lachesis and lysines by dispositional understanding. That is the theme of competition, animal theme, vivaciousness. Lachesis has clairvoyance, sexuality. Lysine is a terror, furor, violent remedy, and also tissue affinity. Lysine is more towards the CNS and sexual system. So I go towards the China considering tissue affinity and all these things, blood and circulation. And considering pathology, it is the hormonal suppression of bone marrow, which is immune mediated, which is syphilis, because it is going to end the life. If we not interfere at a time, patient is surely going to die. Even if bone marrow transplant is there, after bone marrow transplantation, that is survival rate is about 5 years. So I consider his faulty perception, why there is bone marrow is shutting down, and tissue affinity. And on 26 October, when he get admitted in hospital, I started China 201 packet. At that time, HB was 10.2. And I kept him on SL. I waited till 19 October, but his HB was consistently falling down. On 19 October, HB was 5.9, WBC 3,100, and platelets are 16,000. So I may think that I have to go for repetitions. Then I made China 3 packets and waited till for 15 days. On 13 October, again HB fall down to 4.9 and platelets 18,000, WBC 3,000. Then I made China 200 diluted daily. And I kept as it is China 200 daily diluted till 14 November. But HB was falling consistently down. At that 14 November, HB became 3.9, WBC 3,000 and platelets 16,000. There is much distress patient is feeling. So I advise him to take BT. BT was taken on 14 November. I made China 1M. But his HB after blood transfusion became 5.9, which again fall down to 4.9. So I feel that analysis of remedy response, that is the no response of China in spite of changing potency and repetition. There is no arrest of disease activity as HB is falling down consistently and also subjective distress get increased. So there is no indication to change the clinical thinking. So I have to change the remedy. Then I revise the totality, and problem in understanding the patient's wrong conception is there. So I use concept of German new medicine that the bone marrow get affected when patient feels self-devaluation conflict. So this is the review totality, tissue affinity, bone marrow affection. I thought I have to address the pathology, its space, its violence, so rapid space, sudden manifestation. That is the within 2 months, HB fall down to 1.8. So it is a very rapid and violent process that is the going on. And I consider delusion insulted, he or she is, and dead desire. Because patient says that, malas kaitari vahav, he aiknepeksha mi melu kane. And I refer to our aphorisms 211 and 212, that is the state of disposition of the patient often chiefly determines the selection of the homeopathic remedy. So this is the repertorization, where the belladonna is the only remedy come forward. Other is nitric acid and sulfur, but they are not covering, that is the his faulty perception, that is delusion insulted he is. At this time, I refer to Metra Medica, but I am not getting references of bone marrow affinity. So I found it in Vitalcus Metra Medica, that is the inflammation of bone marrows. Then I referred one research paper, Yasin Ghulam. He said that ITPs and blood disorder can be cured by homeopathy. Then at alkaloid levels, belladonna has atropine and scopolamine, that is the anticholinergic alkaloids, and other is hyoscine. It is the bone marrow cells and receptor. I am trying to understand bone marrow from molecular biology point of view. That is the mesenchymal stem cells from the bone marrow expresses a unique set of chemokine receptors. The loss of chemokine receptor expression is accompanied by decreased expressions of adhesion molecules. The changes in bone marrow stem cell phenotype is associated with slowing of cell growth and increased spontaneous apoptosis. That is the when chemokine receptors get lost, that at that time cells phenotype get changed and your cell growth goes down, and it is a spontaneous apoptosis that bone marrow cells get replaced by fat cells and bone marrow glia becomes aplastic. Also, I am trying to find out belladonna alkaloids on which receptors they are acting. So scopolamine is the chemokine receptor antagonist. It acts against chemokine receptor. It blocks the chemokine receptor. It is also muscarinic receptor antagonist. It inhibits chemokine receptor by binding to chemokines. That is a chemokine receptor, and chemokines is the important for inflammation and also for bone marrow stem cells expression. So it is indirectly, I am correlating it with homeopathy. That is the belladonna is have tissue affinity for bone marrow, that is acting through receptors. This is my understanding from molecular biology point of view. On 13-12, I started belladonna 200, at that time HB was 4.9, WBC 3300 and platelets are 16,000. On 6 Jan, HB fall down 4.7, WBC 2700 and platelets increased to 21,000. So I decided to wait and watch. I kept belladonna 200 as it is till 10-2, when HB increased to 4.7, it is by 0.5, but platelets are consistently increasing and WBC is around 2500. So I kept belladonna 200 as it is. On 22 Feb, HB came to 5.4 and WBC 2800 and platelets 45,000. So HB is going up consistently, and also WBC at somewhat level and platelets also. So what decided potency selection? I referred to aphorism 247. That is, it is impractical to repeat the same dose again. So that dose has already satisfied the susceptibility for that potency. So we have to increase potency every time slightly. That is 200, 201. It is given in 247. So it satisfies the susceptibility of Poiteuille force. And also in 248, how long are we going to repeat? It is going to repeat in chronic disease for daily for months till homeopathic aggravation. And homeopathic aggravation took place at the end of cure. It is clearly given in 248. So on date April and May, there is a lockdown going on. So patient is not able to come for follow-up. He talked on phone. I kept belladonna 200 as it is diluted. And in last follow-up, when 7 July, at that time HB was 10.8, WBC 2500 and platelets are 43,000. No blood transfusion given since starting of belladonna, and HB is growing on consistently. This is the last report when HB is 10.8. The analysis of belladonna, analysis and precautions. That is, since starting of belladonna, there is no blood transfusion, which was previously, he has to take blood transfusion within 15 days to 1 month. But WBC and platelets are less than earlier, but not to normal level. So there is a risk of infection because of WBC on lower side, that is 2,500, and platelets are 43,000. So risk of bleeding is there. So we have to be very cautious till WBC and platelets get normalized. Then I am thinking, that is the registration at level of RBCs. RBCs is going on, but platelets and WBCs are partially responding. So whether there is any anti-miasmatic required, there is miasmatic block, I have to remove that. So I am thinking to give up anti-miasmatic remedy. And also I am thinking to get touch in hematologist, because to further exploration of dimensions of the case, why that WBCs and platelets are not increasing. So my learning from this case is importance of receiving of the patient in a holistic way to identify the mental state. Because if we go directly for interpretation, there is a lot of risk of doing mistakes and disposition at the onset of illness. That is the mental state and disposition that is given in operation 211. The onset of illness is much important. Also, importance of understanding of faulty perception of the patient and correlating it with the image of Matra Medica. Importance of understanding tissue affinity of the remedy, because I had taken the rubric RB impaired production of RBC. Because here in patient aplastic anemia or trialineage, that is the WBC, platelets and RBC all get depressed. That is the rubric was not appropriate. And in bone marrow affinity, it covers the all. So importance of affinity of tissue is the important. Important of consulting organ in defining posology and repetition, which is 247, 248. This is our hospital, Hahnemann Homeopathic Hospital. This is the entrance, this is the waiting area, this is the reception, and this is the cabin, consulting chamber. This is the pharmacy, this is the general ward, and below are special rooms. It is 20-bedded hospital and 8 dedicated directors. Dr. Rahul Shirkande, alumni MLD MHI 2008, MD Matra Medica. Dr. Praveen Bilare, MLD MHI 2017. MD Organon, myself Dr. Sukhdev Apte, MD Pediatrics, MLD MHI alumni 2007, Dr. Jawaharlal Shah, MD Homeopathy from Nagar College, Dr. Abhay Chavan, MD Organon from Nagar College, Dr. Praveen Bilare, and Dr. Siddharth Mane, BHMS, and Dr. Abhijit Kuchekar, BHMS. And Dr. Abhijit Gurav, MD Organon from Nagar College. We does various activity of hospital. We run pre-vitiligo OPD every month on last Sunday. We started pre-OPD till COVID pandemic will be over. Wednesday morning, there are the live case discussions for all homeopathic doctors. Case presentation for general practitioner on every third Sunday morning. Pre-camps of different medical conditions twice a month. Joining of entrance, we are planning to schedule their training programs, social awareness programs for the community. This is the statistics of first year of our hospital. We had done total 129 admissions. There are variety of diagnoses, 49 types. In that, we cured and improved cases 101. Few cases of 23 cases referred to multi-specialty hospital due to not manageable. And 5 deaths are there, which are terminal cases, which are referred to from multi-specialty hospital, that is, this is a hopeless case, take it to home. We took that all type of cases. This is the variety of diagnosis which we had treated in our hospital. That is colitis, septicemia, acute GIT, various viral fevers, pneumonia, TB meningitis, concussions, cellulitis, various psychiatric cases, CVA, coronary artery disease, rickettsial fever, cerebral ataxia, ulcerative colitis, mononeuritis multiplex, acute renal failure, muscular dystrophy, motor neuron diseases, sagittal venous thrombosis, like this. I am thankful to Dr. Kumar Dose sir, who always guides us. I am thankful to Vipin sir, who always gives valuable insight about ICR teaching. I am thankful to NL Tiwari sir, Dr. Manoj Patel sir, Dr. AR Kapse sir, Dr. Prashant Tambodi sir, Dr. SK Pansalkar sir, Dr. Goda sir, Dr. Sunita Nikum madam. I am also thankful to Dr. Kavir Vakharia for his technical assistance and help. I am thankful to all faculty of MLD-MHI. I am thankful to all our directors, Jawaharlal Shah, Dr. Rahul Shirkande, Dr. Abhijit Kuchekar, Dr. Abhijit Gurav, Dr. Abhishek Chavan, Dr. Siddharth Mane, Dr. Praveen Bilare. I am also thankful to associated doctors of our hospital and general practitioner who constantly cooperated with us and supports our hospital. I am thankful to Principal Dr. Ravindra Bhosle sir, Dr. Mrs. Palekar, and Savkar Homeopathic Medical staff and students. And last but not least, I am thankful to patients who strongly believe in homeopathy and taken homeopathy. Thank you.